everybody. Thanks for coming to class today. Remember today we talked about how we can't always translate from Spanish to English or from English to Spanish because of cultural differences, because sometimes there are more words in the other language than we have in English. And one of those examples that we talked about tonight was ser and estar. So both of these mean to be. So for example, soy and estoy both translate to I am. You are could be tú eres, tú estás. He is, él es, él está. So we have to kind of understand context when we're trying to translate this, since it means the exact same thing in English. So the basic guidelines for ser we use with physical permanent characteristics. With estar, we use more temporary characteristics. So if you remember the rhyme that I showed you, it might be easier to remember. For how you feel and where you are, always use the verb estar. So how you feel, where you are, your location, those are things that change quite often. So we want to use the verb estar for those. So let's look at some examples that we talked about. For example, the apple is green. We can say la manzana es verde, meaning that the apple is a green apple. It's permanently, it's a Granny Smith apple. If I say la manzana está verde, that means that the apple is temporarily green now because it's still raw. So, for example, in English, if I told you the banana was green, you would automatically know, oh, it's green because it's raw. It's not ripe yet, so I need to wait for it to be ripe. All right, so in that case, I would say el plátano, la banana, está verde. It's green. If I want to describe its color, I would say el plátano es amarillo because bananas are yellow. All right, another example. Marisol is thin. If I said Marisol es delgada, then she's always been a thin person. She can eat whatever she wants and she's fine. If I say Marisol está delgada, that implies that there's been a change in her characteristics. It might be temporary. So I'd be surprised that she lost a lot of weight. So she looks great now because she's lost so much weight. So those are just a couple of examples. Remember that we learned doctor place as an acronym to remember exactly when we use them in more detail. So for ser, we have doctor, which is date, occupation, characteristics, time, origin, and relation. And for place, we use for estar, so position, location, which could mean the same things, action, which is the present progressive, like I am doing something. And condition and emotion, which again could mean the same things. All right, remember if you want to translate, the best options, in my opinion, are these two websites that I put in the chat. The first one, spanishdict.com. So that's a really good dictionary to use, and sometimes you can even translate full sentences. The second one is wordreference.com, wordreference.com. So that one is great because it gives you different contexts for when to use a word. It gives you what country uses different words, like bus, for example. There's a lot of different words for bus depending on what country you go to. So you'd want to know if you're traveling somewhere what the word for that was. And sometimes it's the same word, and it kind of lets you know that. All right, and then for Google Translate or other websites like it, those are really good resources if you need to have a quick translation, or if you kind of already know what you want to say and you're able to correct it if it does make a mistake. All right, so I hope you enjoy the lesson, and I hope I see you again in another class. Adios.